In Lesson 4.6, students are introduced to Lewis dot diagrams, or Lewis dot structures. The lesson uses a periodic table of energy level models that they've seen before, and a periodic table of Lewis dot structures, which they haven't seen, and we compare the two to see how they're related. Now, it can be a little confusing for kids because the way we show the electrons in the energy levels, they're evenly spread out on any given energy level. For instance, oxygen. It has 8 protons, so it has 8 electrons. There's 2 on the first and 6 on the second. Now, we've shown them spread out evenly on the second energy level. We've been consistent in doing that throughout our discussion of energy levels. In Lewis dot structures for oxygen, they'll only show electrons on the outermost energy level, so there's 6 electrons, but they don't show them evenly spread out. The way Lewis dot structures work is that kids put a dot, let's say at 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 9 o'clock, and then another one here and another one here. So they're not evenly spread out. That is a convenient way of being able to show bonding in Lewis dot structures. You're going to have to explain to kids that even though they're spread out evenly in the energy level model, they're grouped in little pairs of 2 when they have to be in the Lewis dot structure model. You probably need to tell students never put them in sets of 2 until you kind of have to. Until the 4 places are used up with 1, then you can begin putting another one to make 2 in any given spot. We'll see how it works in a minute when we combine elements to make molecules. Let's take a look. Here's a simple way of showing a Lewis dot structure for hydrogen. In this case, a hydrogen molecule, H2. So just like kids have seen before in chapter 4, 2 hydrogen atoms get close together. Their mutual attraction causes the sharing of electrons. Electron will be attracted to this proton, this electron will be attracted to that proton, and they'll have the sharing of electrons and form a covalent bond. Well, in a Lewis dot structure, it's a very similar situation. You show 1 dot for the electron for hydrogen. When they come together, you show 2 dots as the covalent bond between them. But then they take it a step further and use a line to indicate the covalent bond. So this, in Lewis dot structure, is a hydrogen molecule, H2. So how about for water? Again, students have already seen that in a water molecule, the hydrogens share electrons with the oxygen, and that's what forms the covalent bond, is the mutual attraction for electrons between the atoms. So in a Lewis structure, you would show the oxygen in this way. You don't necessarily have to show 2 here or 2 here. 2 here and 2 here would be okay. As long as you have a pair of electrons and another pair of electrons, and then you have 2 electrons by themselves here. In this case, we've chosen to show the shape of the molecule. Not all Lewis structures of H2O will do this. Some will be linear. But we did this to reflect the shape of the molecule that students are familiar with. And in this case, the 1 electron from hydrogen is shared with the 1 electron from oxygen. And that happens in both cases. We just sort of shifted the molecule around so it would have the familiar look of H2O. What's important is that the covalent bond is indicated by the oxygen and the hydrogen with the pair of electrons between them. And then you can convert those into lines, and that's the Lewis dot structure for H2O that shows the shape of the molecule also. For an oxygen molecule, O2, just like kids have seen before, you have the energy level models. The electrons from this oxygen atom are attracted to the proton from this oxygen atom, and these electrons are attracted to that proton, and you have a sharing of electrons. In this case, you've got a double bond because 2 electrons are shared from this oxygen and 2 electrons are shared from this one. So you end up with a total of 8 electrons in the outer energy level of this oxygen and a total of 8 in this one. And the way that would be shown in a Lewis structure is very similar, where you have, instead of them all spread out like this, you have them grouped the way you have to do in a Lewis structure, and you end up with a single electron here and here in this oxygen and the same in this one. And then we just kind of move those around in order to show that you have a double bond here where you're sharing not only two electrons, but you're sharing four total electrons between the atoms. And you can convert those to lines. That's what O2 looks like in a Lewis structure. You can also use Lewis dot diagrams to show ionic bonding. In this case, we'll use our classic example of sodium and chlorine, where the sodium loses an electron and the chlorine gains one. So the sodium becomes a positive ion and the chlorine becomes a negative ion, and then they come together and form a bond. We can start off with the atoms, sodium and chlorine, but then the ions are shown with brackets, with a charge outside the bracket. So in this case, the sodium has no dot anymore because it lost it to the chlorine. So its outer electron level is empty, and it has a plus sign. And here the chlorine gained an electron, so its outer energy level has 8, and it has a minus sign. And then they come together and form an ionic bond. If you're in an NGSS state, there's a performance expectation, MSPS-1-1, which says, develop models to describe the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures. Well, in this case, we're using Lewis dot diagrams as models to show the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures in the case of sodium chloride. If you look at the foundation boxes, students develop a model to describe phenomena. Well, in this case, they're developing a model to describe covalent and ionic bonding. The disciplinary core idea is that substances are made from different types of atoms, and each pure substance has characteristic physical and chemical properties. In this case, students show that substances are made from different types of atoms. They use the Lewis dot structures to show that. And time, space, and energy phenomena can be observed at various scales. In this case, students use models that rely on looking at the electrons in the outer energy level in order to show how atoms come together to form molecules. So thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.